السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبيه المصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. وبعد، I pray to the Almighty Allah to make this day a blessed day for all of us. It is Friday and here in the Middle East it is after Jumu'ah prayer, and it is a time to bury Sheikh Muhammad al-Sharif. May Allah have mercy on him. And no matter what I say, I'm not going to pay him enough, but I pray that the Almighty Allah will bless his soul and raise him into the highest ranks in the gardens of paradise. Ameen. Such a wonderful person. And one of his speeches, he was speaking about death and a particular hadith in which Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَاتَ الْيَوْمَ رَجُلٌ صَالِحٌ. Today, a righteous man passed away. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged his companions to pray for him. And now it is time to pray for our brother Muhammad al-Sharif, whom we believe, and Allah knows best, that he was a righteous man. He was a pioneer in the field of da'wah. Since his youth, he was thinking out of the box. So he took the da'wah into a totally different level. Not just da'wah in the masjid, but rather producing du'a and scholars through Al-Maghrib Institute, which graduated and produced a lot of imams, khatibs, scholars, du'a, men and women, and people whom the religious education benefited them personally. So may Allah bless his soul. And while he's being buried right now, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once on burying one of his companions, the Sahaba were fixing to leave. He said, wait a minute. استغفروا لأخيكم وسلوا الله له التثبيت فإنه الآن يسأل. He said, seek forgiveness for your brother. Do not rush to leave from the graveyard. Hang on 15, 20 minutes, 30 minutes to seek forgiveness for your brother and ask Allah the Almighty to give him steadfastness and confirmation of the statement of the Tawheed. فَإِنَّهُ الْآنَ يُسْأَلُ. Since now he's being questioned. Once a person dies, any person, Muslim or non-Muslim, فَيَأْتِيَانِهِ مَلَكَانِ, two angels by the name Munkar and Nakir will come to the person who was just buried, فَيُقْعِدَانِهِ, and they will set him up. But we buried him under the dirt, under the sand and the dust. The angels will set him up, and then they will ask him three questions, which every one of us as Muslims know in advance. Imagine going to the final examination with the question sheet, which you already know the questions in advance. It should be a lot easier for you versus a person who doesn't know what will the questions be all about. So the questions will be, مَا رَبُّكْ وَمَا دِينُكْ وَمَا تَقُولُ فِي الرَّجُلِ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ, who's your Lord, whom do you worship? مَا دِينُكْ, what is your faith, what is your belief, what is your religion? And what do you say concerning the man who have been sent to you, without naming him, without saying that, what do you think? And what do you say concerning Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So brothers and sisters, I pray that when Muhammad al-Sharif will be asked, مَا تَقُولُ فِي الرَّجُلِ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ, you say, I have been teaching his sunnah, I have been teaching his guidance for the past 30 or plus more years. SubhanAllah. May Allah have mercy on him. As you all know that when the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إذا مات العبد انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث. Whenever the servant of Allah dies, all his or her deeds come to end. There is no way that they can earn reward and good deeds anymore because they are not able to say or do good deeds anymore. إلا من ثلاث, except through three avenues. One of them is أو علم ينتفع به, leaving behind the legacy of useful knowledge that which people will benefit out of it. So subhanallah, we believe our beloved brother Muhammad al-Sharif have left behind an amazing legacy in the form of publications, in the form of audio and video materials, in the form of thousands and thousands of graduates of Al-Maghrib Institute for the past 20 plus years, mashallah, who are educated Muslims, who are able to be good spouses, good parents, good dua by the grace of Allah. So this is an amazing job that he has done, and we hope and we pray that Allah will keep all of that in his scale of good deeds. Also, for us as a reminder, Muhammad al-Sharif was almost my age and Mufti Mink's age. Just was a healthy person. He never complained of any sickness or heart disease or lung or pulmonary diseases. He didn't have COVID like many of us. He was perfectly healthy. Then all of a sudden, and a few minutes after the final post that he posted on his page, all of a sudden his death was announced. The Almighty Allah says by the end of Surah Luqman, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. سبحان الله. In this ayah, the Almighty says, مَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. No soul knows what will it earn tomorrow. What is hidden for us in the next moment, we have no clue about it. What is ahead of us, not only tomorrow, but the moment which is right after this moment. The second after the second. You're walking on foot, then you're gone. What do we say? وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتٌ. And no soul knows where it will die and eventually when or how. Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah have mercy on him, accordingly made this beautiful poetry when he said, تَزَوَّدْ مِنَ التَّقْوَى فَإِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي إذا جن ليل هل تعيش إلى الفجر فكم من فتى أمسى وأصبح ضاحكا وقد نسجت أكفانه وهو لا يدري وكم من عروس زينوها لزوجها وقد قبضت أرواحهم ليلة القدر وكم من صحيح مات من غير علة وكم من سقيم عاش حينا من الدهر وكم من صغار يرتجى طول عمره وقد أدخلت أجسادهم ظلمة القبر. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah be pleased with him, says, you better prepare yourself for that moment by seeking as much provision of taqwa, righteousness, and fear of Allah, piety and righteousness as much as you can. Because you never know when will you die and how will you die. Well, unfortunately, angel of death does not give any indication, does not drop us a message or a phone call or even a missed call to say, hey, I'm coming tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. or a.m. or even I'm coming at all. He just shows up, maybe while you're eating, maybe while you're intimate with your spouse, maybe while driving, maybe while praying, maybe while fasting, maybe while committing a sin. And that's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, من صام يوما في سبيل الله ختم له بصوم دخل الجنة. Whoever dies while fasting or after breaking his fast shall enter paradise. تصدق بصدقة فختم له بها دخل الجنة. So what matters is the conclusion of your life. In which condition you die? Our beloved brother Muhammad al-Sharif filled his life and kept on busy all the time with educating the Ummah. We're raising the awareness of Allah's presence with the importance of dua, and I think this is what he needs most right now. Inni da'in fa'aminu. I'm going to pray for Muhammad al-Sharif, whom we hope and we pray that he will be accepted by Allah, because we bear witness for him that he was a righteous man and he was a good teacher and a great da'iyah. So join me by saying Ameen. اللهم يا واسع الفضل يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد في الأولين وفي الآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اغفر لعبدك محمد الشريف وارحمه رحمة واسعة. اللهم أسكنه فسيح جناتك. اللهم اغسله من ذنوبه ومن خطاياه بالثلج والماء والبرد. اللهم نقه من خطاياه كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. اللهم باعد بينه وبين ذنوبه وخطاياه كما باعدت بين المشرق والمغرب. نعم. اللهم اجعل قبره روضة من رياض الجنة ولا تجعله حفرة من حفر النار. اللهم وسع له في قبره مد بصره. اللهم آنس وحشته في قبره. اللهم بيض وجهه ونور قبره وأفسح له في قبره مد بصره. اللهم أبدله دارا خيرا من داره وأهلا خيرا من أهله وناسا خيرا من ناسه. اللهم اخلفه خيرا في عقبه. اللهم اخلفه خيرا في زوجه وأهله وماله وولده. اللهم اجعل ولده خير خلف لخير سلف. اللهم صبر زوجه. اللهم صبر أهله. اللهم صبر ولده. اللهم صبرهم على ما ابتليتهم به وأبدلهم خيرا مما أخذت منهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم ألحقنا وإياه بالصالحين في جنات النعيم. اللهم ارفع درجاته في عليين. اللهم ثبته عند السؤال. اللهم لقنه حجته. اللهم إن أتاه الملكان فسألاني من ربك وما دينك وما تقول في الرجل الذي بعث فيكم، فلقنه حجته وثبته عند السؤال كما قلت يا ربنا يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ويضل الله الظالمين ويفعل الله ما يشاء. My dear brothers and sisters, this is what he needs most right now. استغفروا لأخيه وسألوا الله له التثبيت فإنه الآن يسأل. Seek forgiveness for your brother and ask Allah to keep him firm at the time of answering the questions. Indeed, he is being questioned right now. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama taslima kathira. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.